Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In part 4 of this video series, we'll composite our crosshair into the binocular scope and add a bit of animation to enhance it. Now we will be doing some tracking in this video. In order to do any tracking in action, you need to connect the background because we always track on the background as the reference. Next, we need to add the crosshair. Double-click on the action node. Now press Ctrl N to add a new media input. Connect the color frame to the red front input. And connect the G-mask node to the blue alpha input. Ensuring the action node is selected, you will see the crosshair composited in the result view. Hovering over the ConnectFX schematic, press the Escape keyboard shortcut to bring up the action schematic view. If you need to, pan the schematic view using Control Command. Now we would like to track the crosshair to one of the small buildings in the distance. To start the tracking, double-click on the axis node of the crosshair image object. In the object menu, click the stabilizer button to enter into the tracking tools. As a reminder, the image you see here is the background connected into the action node in ConnectFX. Now, this is not something I would normally do, but it will give you practice when tracking objects moving off screen. Pick up the tracker box and place it on the small object in the field. Press Analyze, but as soon as the object goes off screen, click anywhere to halt the track. If you have any crazy keyframes, press Option D a few times until all the bad keyframes are gone. So to change a tracking reference in the middle of a track, change the Tools pull-down menu from Select to Add Points. Hold Ctrl Shift and pick up the tracker box and move it to another object in the field. This sets a new reference at this frame we are on, but it doesn't disturb the previously tracked keyframes. Press Analyze to pick up from where we left off. Once the tracking is done, you can scrub the time bar to check the track. If you are happy with the result, press the Return button to exit the stabilizer. In action, ensure you are on frame 1. Now this tracking data is in this axis node, so we must not adjust it. To do any offsets, we need to add another axis node. Switch to the Action Bin menu. Drag out an axis node and drop it into the connection underneath the tracking axis. Now double-click on this axis to bring up its object menu. Scale the crosshair down to 15% and position it over this building. To add to the effect, we will reveal the crosshair by scaling it up using animation. On frame 1, turn on Auto Key. Set the scale to 0%. Go 6 frames forward. Set the scale to 25%. Finally, go 2 more frames forward and set the scale back to 15%. Turn Auto Key off. This will create a popping effect when the crosshair appears over 8 frames. Now I'd like to have another 2 more crosshairs appear, but offset in time. We can reuse the tracking data in the top axis node, as well as use actions instancing capabilities. Select the node containing the animation and the offset. Press Command D twice to duplicate it. Now just spread the nodes out a bit. Connect the tracking data to each of the new nodes. Next, connect each of the axis nodes to the crosshair image object. By having multiple axis nodes connected to a single image object creates instances. This will all become clear in a few seconds. Select the second axis. Move the crosshairs over to the far right of the scope and decide on a final position. Now select the third axis and position it over the other building. When you scrub the time bar between the first and 8 frames, you will see all 3 crosshairs appear simultaneously. If that is what you want, then great. But I'd like to have them appear one after the next. To do this, we will use the Animation Tracks Editor. switch to the animation editor. Change the view mode from channels to tracks. Hold down Command and draw a selection box over the second and third axis node. If you don't see anything highlighting in the scroll bar, scroll down to the highlighted action node and expand it. This will eventually reveal the selected axis nodes. Click the Frame All button to fit all exposed animation tracks to the window. Go to frame 14 in the time bar. Now drag the middle control point of the second axis to start its animation at frame 14. So the animation is 8 frames with a 6 frame delay. Click the timecode slider and type 14 and click the Add button. Press Enter to close the calculator. Now drag the middle control point of the third axis to start its animation at frame 28. If you scrub the time bar now, you will see the delayed animation. Smoke also has the option to apply offset animation expressions, but we won't be covering that in this video series. In the next video, we will add a few lens characteristics to the scope POV to improve the look. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.